We thank you, Father, for protecting us. We thank you tonight for healing us, keeping us well, Father, keeping us safe, protecting our homes, our cars, our incomes. And we thank you, Father, that in this economy that we're striving, we need not for anything. Everything we have, you've given us. And we're so thankful, Father. We're so thankful. We're so blessed to be your children. And we thank you for seeing about us, for taking care of us, for honoring us, for honoring your word, for keeping your word. And we thank you, Lord, how we strive, we live, we breathe, and we eat those words daily. It is our survival. Nothing we do, Father, we do without you. You are everything to us. You're our life, our air, our energy, our hearts, our minds. You are in us and we're in you. We're one and the same. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you for having your eyes, Father, that we see the world the way you see the world. Glory, glory, glory. For the world sees hate, we see love. For the world sees emptiness and pain, we see joy and fulfillment. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. And we give you praise, Father. We give you glory, Father. We give you honor, Father. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, 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 glory. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Horate ki de brede de kan. Horace kur varate shand. We thank you for this ministry, Father. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. This is truly the house that you built, Father. Horate ki de brede kan. Bless your holy name, Lord. Bless your holy name. We give you praise tonight. We give you glory tonight. We worship you, Father. There's no other like you, Lord. There's no other like you. You're so wonderful, Father. You are wonderful. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. And we honor you, Father. Glory, 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 glory. When we hurt, you ease our pains. When we weary, you remove our doubts. Glory, 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 glory. We've learned to lay all of our cares at your feet. And we can walk away with peace of mind. That has been taken care of, that is done. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. Glory, glory, glory. In Jesus' name, Lord, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. This is your day, Father, the day you made for us. And we thank you, Lord, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for these sisters and brothers that come out tonight. They honor you, Father. They're hungry for you, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We give you praise, Father. We give you glory, Father. We give you honor, Father. In Jesus' name, Lord. In Jesus' name. Orete kira barate shand. Orese kira barate kind. Orete kura barate kada bredete kind. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you tonight for this 5-4 ministry, Father. We thank you for the service yesterday. We thank you for the word, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you for this wonderful house of prayer. In Jesus' name, Lord. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. Well, sisters and brothers, this is a good opportunity for us to just kind of fellowship with each other a little bit, like we do. And if you have some encouraging words and the testimonies, anything you'd like to share tonight. It's always good to hear from our saints. Glory, glory, glory.
Scripture, because I'm gonna when you come back, I'm gonna ask y'all these scriptures, and that's how I really learned. I don't know scripture and verse, but I know a lot of scriptures. You know what I'm saying? When you started out, I can finish
right,
it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But I just thank God for the teaching here and the love. Sister Hill, Pastor Hill got a wonderful wife. It wouldn't be for her. You know, I how she stick by her husband, you know, and I look at that a lot, you know, and the things that she says stays with me through the day, through the weeks, through the months, through the years, about how I conduct myself, you know, because it's what you say and let out of your mouth. I always think about Sister Hill. I'll say, well, you know, if you tell one person, that person don't mean that you say, don't tell nobody now. You know, and I always bring me back to not to really down people. You know, I just don't, that's just not in my nature anyway, but I always, when I do try to knock somebody when they really done me wrong, I say, Judy, just put it in God's hands. And I learned that being in here. And like I said, in the Monday night, Brother Travis, you just a blessing, you know. And like I said, I'd rather give people their flowers while they're living, you know. And you're a blessing. And, you know, I just like the way you bring forth. And that's why I hate when I miss, because it's the love that you share for people. You know what I'm saying? And everybody don't probably like understand you, or because you always talk about love all the time. How can you love everybody? You know what I'm saying? But that's the love of God. You know what I'm saying? And you always show love. And I just wanted to say that too, because like I said, you're a blessing too. And like I said, if I wasn't receiving anything, I wouldn't be here. You know what I'm saying? So like I said, you're a blessing, and the ministry is a blessing. And the people in the ministry are a blessing to me. And I'm just glad that I'm here. That, like I said, when I get sick, I think about that a lot. I said, whatever I sow, you know what I'm saying? I would want that back if I got sick. You know what I'm saying? That's why I try to be a blessing to people with an encouraging word. You know where? You know what I'm saying? I try to encourage people, you know, because that's what I want, you know? Especially if I get down on my back. Just call me. Like I said, you know, I got to say hi, you know. And, just everything, pass it on, yeah. So God has been a blessing to me in this ministry. And like I said, I ain't going nowhere.
All that you can talk. I know you got something to say. Yeah, come on, man. You're a blessing to me.
Yeah,
she gave it to me.
But I'm God. Yeah, praise God. I'm blessed every day.
You're doing so good.
He's my healer, my comforter when I go home at night and any time of the day. And I'm just me and him. We be a talking, I be a singing, because I live alone, and it's life to be alone. So I give that to God. When I feel like I can think of my niece and it'll be in tears, and a scripture comes to mind that she says a lot, that choose you this day, who you gonna serve. And she hung that in her house, and that was her favorite scripture. And so when I think of that, her, I say, choose you this day, honey. I did just like you. I chose this day to follow God. That means the best to me. And I appreciate you too. Very much. And I'm glad I can start coming back to prayer meetings. Bible studies on Wednesday mornings and Sundays. I want to come to Sunday school more, because I love hearing about the word more. Pastor Hill teaches it good, but Brother Williams, you can break it down. If I ask him something, he break it down for me. So I like Sunday school too.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm glad I'm in this church. And I love going to Sunday school, because Sunday school, that just brings it out to me, you know. And I have a good day. And I thank the Lord for Pastor Hill and Sister Hill. You know, my brothers and sisters in the Lord.
Yes.
And I don't know, I tell you what, it's just wonderful. God is good. And Travis,
you see your family too?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I appreciate you too, Travis. I appreciate Monday night. Like I said, they say, oh girl, you're going in the morning, why are you going tonight? You know, I said, I got to go.
I know.
Monday night, I don't care what be going on. Monday night, I have to come to intercession prayer. Wednesday night, I have to come to Bible study. And it's just, you know, it's just growing on me. And I'm glad, because, I don't know, it does something to me. It picks me up.
Yes.
You know, God is good. It's like he went on the cross for us.
Right.
And, you know, I think about that, how they did him on the cross, and then they took every sickness, every time a sickness tried to come upon you, we need to bind it in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
But Jesus took that on the cross.
That's right.
He did everything we talk about, aches and pains, he's already taken it, he's already, you know, took it away from us, and that's what we should say. We should say when you try to come upon us, honey, we bind it right there in the name of Jesus, get off of this body, you can't deal with the body. This is God's body. You ain't got no place here. Oh, and I get happy about the word. And I tell you what, I can be like Monday, you know.
I always say Monday's a good day, but you know how people get blue Monday.
Yeah.
But I be glad when Monday come around. It's like Monday evening. Like I just have this. It just look like I'm going to.
Yeah.
You know, the guest somewhere. Yes. Mm-hmm. I have to come and be prayed for and be prayed together. And like I say, I appreciate everybody at this church, and I'm glad I'm at this church. Northside Christian Center is the place.
And when I was down, the church didn't forget about when I was down for 4 months. Mm-hmm. And I want to just give thanks to Brother John and Sister Pearl because they set it up on my computer so I wouldn't miss no Sunday services, no Monday night prayer meetings. And I listen to them. I goes back and go. And he's up over 500 or something. So if you ever want to just go hear the sermon or the prayer night, and I see you and everybody. It was wonderful. So it was a blessing, even when I wasn't here.
Yeah, it's a
show. It's
Brother John.
Wonderful. It's great. It really is. But you know, I sometimes look at Sister Bikes and I really laugh because she was something else. Oh, she was the hardest person, and I don't know the word, you know, but I would call her husband, you know, and out of respect, I said, tell your wife, you know, that I'm calling you because I know he wanted the word, and so I would call him like every 2 weeks, every 3 weeks, and he said, she would say, is that girl again? Because he would always promise that he was coming.
Yeah.
You know, and like you said, you know, somebody, and I knew something about when we came to that door, it was a desire, something was in his heart that he wanted to, but he had to take that first step to do it.
Uh-huh.
And I said, you know, and I couldn't get none of the brothers in the church to do it. You know, and I said, well, I have to do it, and I have to respect her.
Uh-huh.
You know, and I said, and she would say, is that girl? And she is the hardest thing. Pastor Hill said, oh, she's something else. She asked me a thousand questions. And I laughed. And I still got Brother Bikes' thing in my bill thing. And I always, when I go through it sometimes, and I just see his picture, because he was such a joy. And here he comes with his tingling me. I said, why don't he take those keys off? You know, I always remember you and your husband. Y'all was such a joy that I thank God that I followed my spirit, because like I said, I don't know how to witness, but I know love what conquers all. You know, that's how you can win someone, just by showing love.
Because it was Judy. I remember the day I came home from work. He said, three ladies came by the house. I said, what's their name? Dang, I don't know their name. He left this thing here. And it was Judy, Kay, and Denise.
Uh-huh.
And I said, and I just flipped it off and threw it up on the TV and kept on going. I'm going to get you. For weeks, he kept saying, come on, go to church. And the first, back then, Pastor Hill did marriage counsel, beginners, when you come into the church, you had classes. That's what
I'm saying.
And so the first class we came to, I said, and I heard Pastor Hill preach, I said, sound right. And when the next Sunday, he said he had to go somewhere. I said, you ain't going to preach Sunday? I ain't coming if you don't preach. He said, well, sometime we have to give a break. I said, no, you got me started now. If you don't preach, I ain't coming.
We gave him a hard time.
And he preached that Sunday because I kept saying, you don't preach, I ain't gonna come. So they have been a joy in my life.
Yeah.
And like I said, when I testified that day, we went pick greens together. We didn't share a lot. Me and Sister Hill go out to eat lunch, breakfast, whatever. It was just like a big happy family. Because that's the thing. My mama They love greens, and Mama say, I'll take you down there and you can pick some. My mama pick greens so fast, that's he'll say, I know you from the country. They let it down, they bag it out like this. Mama finished, they bag out. But they are enjoying this whole church. It's been a joy to me since I began. And the times I've dropped out, it was because of depression. It wasn't because no member in this church did anything to me. It was just, and it was nothing this church did to make me do it. But it was the church that brought me back.
Yeah, amen, amen.
That's a long stretch.
Jackson, you know you got something good to say.
I know that's right.
No, I don't, but I will. You know, when you talk to Pastor Hill and Miss Hill, you can't help but get joy in your heart.
Yeah, that's
because
right.
Because they are genuine people.
Yeah.
I can remember some years ago before I came to this church, and I was in the Baptist church. Mm-hmm. My brother-in-law there was getting married to Paulette, and I heard all this negative stuff about Northside Christian Center. I heard how, you know, it might have been a cult and sorts of things, you know. But I'm one of them type people, until I find out for myself, I'm not going to, you know, say anything bad or anything like that. But I came here, I believe it was in the month of June. Didn't y'all get married in June? June 7th? I was pretty close. But anyhow, I remember when I came, I sat right over there, and the service was just, the wedding ceremony was just beautiful. Mm-hmm. And then after that, Pastor Hill came over and he talked to me. And, you know, I'm one of the type of people, when I meet someone, you can pretty much tell a good person. And I said, you know, this man is, he's real, you know. And so I decided one Sunday to just come to the church to pay a visit. And when I came, I remember Pastor Hill said, he said, I'm not a hound dog preacher. He said, I more or less like to kind of teach than to be a hound dog preacher because you might miss something. And that's so true because, you know, in a lot of churches you go to, you see these ministers, they get up like, Pastor Williams say, stand up on the ladder and jump off. And, you know, and I've seen stuff like that, you know, in the church. And I've seen people get happy. And those are sometimes tricks. Mm-hmm. Those are sometimes gets you to come back. You know, it's a show.
Yeah.
And I just like things to be real. Mm-hmm. And that's what I learned in this church is Pastor and Missy are both very real people. Not only are they real, the congregation. I was really impressed when I came to the very first Wednesday night service, my very first Wednesday night service. And everybody was taking notes, everybody was quiet, and wasn't no running around, in and out the doors, going back and forth to the restroom and stuff. People come here to learn. And on Wednesday nights, we have what we call School of the Bible. And over the last few years, I've become educated. I've become someone who knows a lot more about the Word than what I used to know. And I thank God for that. I thank God for a pastor who believes in praying.
Yes.
And, you know, I learned a long time ago, prayer will lift the bow down again. Prayer can change things.
Yes.
And, you know, Jesus said the man must always pray. But I can remember years ago, and this one saying always comes to my mind, is it says, you've longed for sweet peace and for faith to increase. Mm-hmm. You've earnestly and you fervently pray. Mm-hmm. You cannot have rest until you're perfectly blessed, mm-hmm. until you're all on the altar is laid. And that's what we do when we come here. We lay it all on the altar. We talk to God. We let God be our guide. We let God be the one that lead us, direct us. He teaches us, and we can have all sorts of problems in our lives, but the one thing I've learned is to come here. I've learned to cast my cares upon the Lord.
Amen.
You can leave them with Him, and He'll take care of you, and
We just have to keep on praying for one another.
One another.
Praying for each and everybody that's on the outside of those doors as well as those on the inside.
Yeah, yeah.
And we just got a good church. That's just all it is to it.
Yeah. Amen.
Should have been back in the gift that you don't get old.
Yeah. Everyone else talking about the goodness of God.
Come on.
All right. The Lord, he blessed today. Today I was emptying the trash trailer because we stay close to Turley. We don't have regular trash service. I got to take my own trash, which is not a problem. I don't have a problem with that. But today, Jonathan and I was, taking the trash, and we were probably maybe about 4 blocks from the place where we was going to dump it, and the tire blew out on the trailer. And if anybody knows, that's the last thing. If you pull in the trailer, that is the last thing you want to do. So we pulled down the street right in front of the, I think it's the YWCA on Pine and, what's that, close to Peoria, right in there. And we were trying to get the lug nuts off, and they were so frozen on there that we couldn't turn them. You know, we didn't have exactly the right tools. And a little while later, a guy came up. He was pulling the trailer. And he had all the tools we need to get that tire changed. And I was just thanking God because, it might seem small, but, when you're out there and you're stranded, you got all that trash on the back of that thing. It was just a real blessing that God would, think enough of me to supply that need when I need it. Because what are the odds of somebody driving by on this back street, dead end street? And I just appreciate the Lord for doing that for me. Yeah.
I don't have a lot to say, but I would just like to tell everyone I love each one of you. I love Travis because of the way he let the Lord use him in transforming his life. From the stories he tells us, we would never imagine he was that kind of person. Because God has transformed him, and he has made him completely new. And when he stands up there letting those words of God come from him, he just shines when he does that.
Yes, he does.
It is so good. And Judy, she is, if the Lord has assigned someone to Judy, there's no one that can reach that person like Judy's
in. That's right. That's true.
Because she has just the right words, just the right smell, just the right hug, just the right laugh to bring that person to where they need to be in God. And Yvonne is a very straightforward person. And I'm sure everyone knows that. She's very straightforward. And she's the kind of person that if she doesn't like something, you know it.
That's right.
Okay,
that's
if she likes something, you know it. Because she is very straightforward. And she's not afraid to tell you anything. But, we need those kind of people.
Yeah, amen.
Because God has something to tell a person. And usually he uses people like Yvonne to do that. And Shirley, I have seen Shirley grow so much. As Pastor Hill said, you couldn't find Sister Shirley when they came from prayer with the search warrant. That's what Pastor Hill said. But just about every Monday, if me and John are late, we see Sister Shirley Clark in the parking lot on Monday night. Because Sister Shirley is committed to prayer. She's committed to Wednesday night. She's even committed to Tuesday. Tuesday night. And I commend her for that, because many Tuesday nights I miss, but Sister Shirley's right there. And Brother Al, I admire you, Brother Al, because for one thing, your height. I just love talking to you. And your deep voice, and I'm waiting to hear you sing. So if God ever puts that on your heart, let him let you sing, Brother Al. And it's one thing that you do. It's one thing that you do that a lot of people at this church wouldn't do. You pray, and you let the word come from your mouth, and you're not afraid to do that. But you haven't been at this church very long, and others have, and I've seen the boldness in you. I love that. Mm-hmm. And my baby. My baby. I love him so much. I've been married 30 years, and I love him so much. I don't want to cry, so I'm not going to get into it. But I love him like no one else could love my husband. You know, we all love each other.
Yes.
But if you love my husband like I love my husband, we would have to sit down and have a talk. because that's my husband.
That's right.
And I'm the one that's supposed to love him the way I love him.
Yeah.
And I do, you know, but it's very easy. The Lord said that, you know, about the husband and the wife. The husband is supposed to love the wife as God loves the church.
That's right.
Well, John loves me like that.
Amen.
And naturally, I love him like that, because he is so good to me.
That's so wonderful.
Amen.
That's wonderful.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
That's wonderful. And I forgot to mention one thing.
Sure.
You can keep it. I probably can talk loud enough. The time was for now. I deliver food. I rode with Brother Travis and Brother Al, and they took care of me, I tell you that. And I thought it was a blessing for me.
Yeah,
I was hopping along with them, but they took care of me. So
that was
I
was good.
Thank them for that. Yeah. It was fun.
It was. It was. We take care of the home.
Yeah. Took care.
Amen.
That's what family do.
And,
you know, I thank all of you for your kind words. And, I just have to tell you that before I got sick, way back when I was a kid, I was a bad kid. I'm not going to lie. But I wasn't a bad kid that didn't care. You know, I always had a heart for others. Always had. And then when I got sick, started dealing with depression and anxieties and demons and the torment and all that stuff. But you know, the devil tried to rob me of all of that. And then there were times through all of that, you know, I gave in to it, and I beat some people up. And there were times that I got beat up, you know, and some other things. I've never been shot, but I've been shot at. I don't know how many people have been shot with a bow and arrow, but I have. I've been burned. I've had a lot of things happen to me, you know, been stabbed, you know, with a stick, you know, and it broke off, and things like that. I could have lost my eyesight, you know, but through all that, you know, I had wood sticking out the side of my head, but I was still trying to kill this kid that did it, you know. But through all of that, I never hated anybody. You know, I was just acting out the things that was driving me to act out. I never acted out in hate, you know, toward anybody. It was just an impulse that I couldn't control. And but throughout all of that, you know, for those 4 years of dealing with that stuff, you know, the devil just could never rob me of caring, you know, for other people. You know, I've always been a giver. And I don't know how to be no other way. You know, it's just in me to do. You know, I got beat real good when I was young for giving my clothes away. You know, I had to tell my mother I gave them away. I just told them they got tore up or they got lost. I left them at school. You know, I couldn't tell her that I was giving clothes away that she was buying me. You know, and it didn't matter to me. I knew I was going to get whooping for it, but that wasn't, it didn't matter. Somebody had a need, and I had to feel that need. And but today, after going through all of that, and being able to come here, and having God lift all of that off of me, you know, what he did was just peel back, you know, that inner thing, that darkness that was holding me in bondage, so that child, you know, could be free to be the person that he was intended to be. But this is what God did to me. He gave me back my life. And within doing that, he renewed me. In the process, he just didn't give me back that person that I knew I was supposed to be, that person that was always inside of me, that was fighting and struggling to get out. He didn't just give me that person back. You know, he made that person better. He renewed that person. He restored that person into his own image. You know, he gave me what I feared most, and my fear was that I lived all those years thinking God didn't love me. And you know, he just gave all of that back to me. And for giving me someone in my life that I could trust, because when you're dealing with that kind of stuff, you don't trust anybody. And that was the reason why I kept all of that a secret all those years. But then this is the way the devil operates. He was killing me slowly. I should have been dead more than I could count on both my hands. But, you know, I just thought it was just luck that was getting me out of it. But I knew at the same time that there was something deeper than just luck. You know, I've lost lots of friends to car wrecks, gunshots, overdoses, you name it, alcoholism, you know, throughout my life. And for a long time, I was very afraid to have a best friend, because they would always die on me. But after he put Paulette in my life, you know, that's when I began to learn to trust someone, you know, and trusting her was what saved my life. Because if I wasn't able to confide in her about my illness, I was getting ready to check out. I was that close to checking out of here. You know, so God, you know, I didn't give him credit then, but I knew it had to be something greater than me. It wasn't just a coincidence that after I come out of a marriage, a failed marriage, that someone like that would come into my life almost instantly. And, you know, but you know, so for all of that, for what Paulette did for me, bringing me here, you know, that wasn't an easy job for her. That wasn't an easy thing for her to do. But once I told her, you know, that I was sick and I needed help, you know, if I didn't get help soon, I was going to die. And once I told her that, and because God said, either tell her or you're going to die. So I did. And everything started falling into place. And once she got me here, I knew I was supposed to be here.
Yeah.
That God didn't want me to be anywhere else. Because this church, you know, it's been a part of me, you know, years before I started coming here, even though I'd never been in these doors before. You know, I mentioned that in my testimony several times, the number of nights that I passed up and down the street, selling drugs, doing drugs, using drugs, and all of that. And it would always be somebody at this church. And that parking lot would be full. And I was slow down, and I could not pass this church without looking over here and saying, what the heck is going on over there? People are always at their church. You know, what are they doing in there? I mean, I could never turn my eyes away from this church. I mean, this went on, you know, back in the 70s, you know, up until 2002. But to tell you why I do what I do now is because God created in me, you know, that spirit, you know, to give, you know, I just give of myself. You know, I don't do it to try to impress nobody. I don't know how to do that. I just do what's in my heart to do. And if I don't do it, then I feel like I'm not doing God justice. He didn't save me just so I could sit out there, you know, and just bask in my own glory, you know, because it's not my glory, you know, it's His glory. I didn't do anything. Only thing I did is say, you know, I give up. I give in, help me. And once I humble myself and said I can't do it no more, I need you. And then He did the rest. I didn't have to do anything else. The only thing He asked me to do is to do what I do on Monday nights, what I do every Sunday, what I do on Wednesdays, and what I do when I'm not in church. You know, is to let people know who He is. And let Him shine through me.
Brother Travis, you have to be a good person for somebody to even mention your name in a good way. And when you joined this church, it was a friend of mine, I probably told you that before. I said, it's a guy who joined our church, and he's a real nice person. He and his wife got married there, and we went on and got to talking. And you know him real well, Billy Johnson. He said, Travis ain't joined our church. I said, you on one side. Like, you know, I can see that what you done there. I only seen you on Christ's side. So she said, Travis ain't joined no church. I said, yes, he did. So I did. I know Travis is telling you the truth. We crossed over from somewhere because I don't know what was back there. They did, and so I want to know this side. So I say, well, he's at our church, and he come faithfully.
Yeah.
And I said, we have to laugh. And so you know, because you know what I'm talking about. So I'm saying that to say you're a good person. Mm-hmm. When someone mentioned you, and somebody else might know you in a different light, but I know you in a good light.
Yeah.
And so
matter of fact, I got a phone call. I get a phone call every Mother's Day, and it's Rochelle. And she called me Sunday, you know, morning. But it just thought how call that to the church.
Yeah.
I can't remember how, because I adopted Rochelle as a daughter, you know, because she was confused and stuff, and I would call her, you know, and just talk to her. And that's when she invited Paulette. And that's how I knew those two were connected.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I remember Paulette coming with Rochelle, you know.
Yeah, I claim Rochelle, you know, she's, you know, and I always tell, you know, if it weren't for you, I wouldn't be here. You know, because she's responsible for two people. You know, because Paulette, you know, she's been in church, but the whole time that we were together, you know, she wasn't going. And,
I don't know.
I'm not quite sure. I know she told me, but it didn't really matter, you know. And she would talk about, you know, Rochelle and stuff. And, you know, like I said, when that day that Paulette came home, you know, and she was totally different, you know.
Yeah.
she was just a different person, you know. She just different, man. And like I said, at that time we were living together, we weren't married. And, you know, and she laid down the law. You know, the first thing she said was, you know, we can't be intimate no more. She said, I'll share my bed with you, but we can't, you know, we can't do that no more until we get married.
She said that too.
We were engaged, you know, we just wasn't in no hurry. You know, because, you know, she'd been married before and I'd been married before, so we wasn't in no hurry. But it was in the works. But once she got me in here, and Pastor Hill got a hold of me, you know, he speeded things up. You know, he speeded things up. He said, oh, well, I told her that we were engaged and we just had to set a date then. But I said, well, you know, what he said, well, you know, I knew what was coming. And you know, I didn't, you know, just met him, you know, and stuff, but I knew the kind of person that it was. Well, I actually knew, because if Paulette was convicted, her conviction, you know, wouldn't allow her, you know, to do what we were doing and stuff, then I knew there was something, you know, powerful going on here. I was suspicious, don't get me wrong. You know, I wanted to come snooping around and, you know, try to peek in the windows and stuff, see what the hell was going on. And made her, you know, but I respect Paula, you know, so I had to honor her wishes, you know, and ideas. And you know, it was, it seemed like it was all for me. You know, it seemed like it all came down to me, because I was the one that really needed it more than she did. I'm not saying that Paula didn't need to be saved, don't get me wrong, but I was the damaged one. I was the one that was, you know, that was about to check out of here. I was the one that was, that God had been chasing him, you know, trying to get me to this place. And it took her, you know, he used her, it took her to get me here. You know, so Paula had served her purpose. So when she left, you know, that's how I had to, you know, that's how I looked at it. You know, if I wasn't a Christian and didn't believe, you know, then I'd have been angry and bitter.
Yeah, that's right.
I never got angry with God about it, you know, because I understood. But, you know, so for me to honor her life and who she is, I have to continue, you know, in my walk. You know, there's no other way. I can never dishonor her, you know, by doing anything different.
Amen.
know, so it's for her, it's for God, it's for Jesus, it's for, you know, it's just the right thing to do, just the honorable thing to do, you know, to honor all of them, you know, for having invested in me like they have, you know, that I can't go back on any of that, you know, so so when I tell you I love you, you know, it's genuine. You know, I don't be saying it to be saying it. But when I come here on Monday nights, I can't wait. You know, I have to, you know, I have to be here. You know, matter of fact, I was here at about 10 minutes after 6. I dropped my grandson off at the gym and I just came home. Because I had some praying I needed to do, and I did that. But you know, this is, you know, this church, this ministry, you know, y'all give me life, y'all give me reason, you know, to be here, to do what I do, you know, and for that, you know, I appreciate it, and I receive it, you know, because all of you, you know, is the reason why I stayed, you know, that and being faithful and, you know, trusting God. But you can't be in a church, you know, it's just like being at your cousin's house and you can't stand it, you know, but you go there, but you go there anyway, but you can't stand being there. You know, how could I be somewhere if I couldn't stand, appreciate the people that's here? You know, I couldn't. So it's the love of you. And who you are, you know, that makes it so easy for me to want to do what I do. It gives me so much joy. So, I thank you. No, I thank you. Thank you so much. All right. So, I guess we can shut her down, so I'll close us out in prayer, all right? Amen. Lord, thank all of you for your comments and your sharing your thoughts. And Brother John, Sister Pearl, y'all are some awesome people. Wonderful couple. Just, I admire you and believe me, I look up to y'all, you know, for what you stand for. Just the love you have. And it's wonderful, you know, to have, you know, a husband that just doesn't love you, you know, and take care of you, you know, he make you laugh, he make you laugh, you know, even when you don't want to laugh, you know. And that's important, you know. You know, to have someone that can bring you up out of the dumps when you're feeling low and won't let you stay there. And so that's who we are to each other. You know, we're down, you know, we build each other up and we comfort each other. And that's the lesson that's being taught here. You know, so I take it all to heart. That's very important to me. And we pass it on, you know, we pass it on to our children, our grandchildren, and our friends, and on the work side, you know, when we at work, okay, I'll say this real quick. When I was working, you know, at PSO, and I had that little building out there to myself, you know, sometimes those guys, you know, these guys that was making three times, you know, an hour more than I was, you know, but when they were around me, it was just like, you know, I was one of them. You know, they never, matter of fact, they would go out of their way. You know, they'll stop by my building, you know, just to holler at me and stuff. And because they knew and they know, you know, who I am and what I do, you know, when they come in there, I don't close my Bible up and put it away so they don't see me reading. You know, I don't do that. You know, when your lights, when your light is shining, yeah. People cannot ignore. They may not say nothing to you, but if they're in your presence, they cannot ignore it. If they're looking at you funny, strange, that's why they're looking at you, because there's something about you and they just can't figure it out. But they're drawn to you, and they want to be around you, near you. And that's what it is. That's the Jesus in you. And it shines, you know, this light shines through us. And that's one of the most honorable things that you can, how you can present yourself when you're out. That people see that in you.
Yes. Amen.
You know, so you know you're doing something right. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
Our Father who art in heaven, we thank you for this day, Lord. We thank you, Father, for all of those who spoke about you and the things that you've done and that you're doing in their lives. We thank you, Father, for honoring us with your presence tonight. We feel you with us, sitting beside us. And we thank you, Lord, that you created us and created in us this, your spirit, the spirit to give, the spirit to care, the spirit of love, the spirit of wanting, the spirit of help, the spirit of understanding. We thank you for making us believers, creating us a heart to believe, a desire to believe. We thank you, Father, that our faith continues to grow and rise daily, that our strength we draw from you, that you are our source. You are everything to us. Nothing we have, we don't have because of you. Everything we have is because of you. You are our provider, our healer, our guide, our nurturer, our teacher. You are who we are. We thank you, Father, for being in us and inviting us in you. We thank you for the fellowship. We thank you that we are Christians, sons and daughters of the Most High God. We thank you, Father, for your love, for the peace, for the joy. We thank you for your grace. We thank you, Father, for your mercy. We thank you for the victories and your favor. We thank you, Lord, for being God and for being our God, our Father. There's no other like you, Lord. Tonight we give you praise, we give you honor, and we give you glory and our love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Because I wouldn't.
Yeah,
when you
Yes.
You know, they just be drawn to you, don't understand.
Yeah. So when you said that, your light be shining. Yours was shining for me, because he mentioned it to my friend. And she told me, I said, yes. So y'all have a blessing.
Yeah, you do.
Thank you.
Nice.
All right, thank y'all for coming out.
Yes. Amen.